Hi everyone. So, it's been a while. I don't think I need to tell you that it's been a very long time since I made a video, and at the time, the main reason for that was that I ran out of things that I was at the time comfortable talking about. But if there's one thing that taking an 8-month break from YouTube helps with, it's having stories to tell. That is to say, a lot of weird shit has happened since I stopped recording. Pumpkin! I have plastic on my bed. I never took it off because I wanted to stay as new as possible for as long as possible. So if you hear crinkling in the background, that is my lovely boy Pumpkin deciding for the fifth time to choose a new place to lay down. Cat shenanigans aside, back on track. Anyways, the first time that I tried to sit down and tell this story, I kind of made it a compilation story time of all of the weird things that have happened with my neighbors. And then I told myself, that is no way to do YouTube. How am I going to get the most content possible if I just say it all in one video and condense it down? That is not how we do things on this website. And I have a lot of recorded speed paints that I need to have audio to. So I sat and I thought about which of the stories might be a good kind of jumping off point to talk about the rest and kind of make a series out of it. And I think the time that I had the police called on me for no good reason is as good a starting place as any. Actually, first of all, I say no good reason, but that implies that there was a reason at all. And there wasn't. That is the biggest kicker of this story. Nothing happened. I did nothing. But okay, that's kind of getting ahead of myself. So I know that when you're listening to someone on YouTube, even if you listen to all of their videos and you think you know them, there's always the fact that you don't actually know them. I'm sitting here telling you stories from my perspective, and there's really no way to truly know what kind of person I am unless you actually know me. But if there's one thing I would hope that you could take from my videos that is true, is that I am not a troublemaker. I am the exact opposite of a troublemaker. If I don't have to defend myself, if I don't feel that I've been wronged, I could not be more of a pacifist. So when it comes to day-to-day life, if anything, I'm kind of a recluse because I'm not a big fan of my neighbors. And especially with what's been going on, that's been even more of an incentive for me to keep to myself. I take daily walks, but besides that, I stay in my house. That's all to say, one of the things that confuses me the most is how my neighbors would even remember me enough to do this. Now, the person in question has known me since I've lived here, so maybe it's a little bit different, but alright, let me just start the story at the beginning. At the time that this went down, or when it began to happen, whatever it is that happened, because I'm still not completely sure, I actually, for once, was not at home. I was going to pick up a friend to bring her back and have her stay the night. So I arrive back. We all get out of the car, we all walk inside, and it couldn't have been 3 minutes in the door that there's a knock. Everyone else had migrated to the backyard besides me and my sister, who was sitting on the couch, so I naturally go to be the one to open the door. And I'm greeted by a police officer. Now, this already has me on edge enough because I'm not gonna get into it, but general feelings about police aside, the police here aren't the best. So I'm already on edge. And I ask, what can I help you with? Like, what's up, dude? How you doing? Why are you at my house? And you can believe me that I've never been so close to shitting my pants when that man looked right at me and said, does Cassian Eubanks live here? Now, my brain went immediately into some kind of meltdown mode, I think, because there was no reason for someone to be calling me out that could be good. I couldn't think of a single damn thing. Like I said, I stay in my house. I am a recluse. Sir, I have done nothing. I don't know what's going on. So actually, the first thing that I did, because again, my sister was sitting on the couch behind me, and obviously she was now alert, like, what the hell? I remember this because in my big sister brain, where everything was already on meltdown, the one thought I had was, well, I'm not getting my sister into it. They've come for me. It is my day to go, but it's not, it doesn't have anything to do with her. So the first thing I did is I stepped fully out onto the front porch and I closed the door behind me. I was like, whatever the hell is going on, I'm just not gonna have her in it. So I'm proud of myself. Big sister vibes. Okay. Okay. Big sister. I've done my job. I've shown that I can be a good big sister. I just completely blocked her out of the trouble. That is such a tangent. Okay. But anyways, point being, I step outside, I close the door behind me, and I'm like, that's me. Please, what is going on? That is me. And he... Okay, I don't know what you might think I was called outside for, but if you know me at all from this channel, it is not anything that you could possibly have expected. Let me tell you that that man looked at me and he said, I was called because of a dispute between you and your boyfriend. Now, I don't know if this is your first video of mine, if you've watched all of my videos, if you know me, if you've partook in any of the lore, but first thing, I am a raging lesbian, and obviously that officer did not know this, and he also didn't know the second thing until I told him. I looked him dead in his eyes, and I hate this because it was my immediate response, and it makes me cringe. I looked right at him, and I just, in a flabbergasted tone, I said, I am single. So, that was my first response, and I mean, I don't know what else I would say in that situation. I am single, sir. I wasn't about to say, I'm a lesbian, sir, because, where I live, that might get me more trouble than it would any kind of pass out of danger. But, suffice to say, I was kind of shocked. I was in a state of slight shock hearing that. And so, I've already embarrassed myself. I look at him and I say, I am single, sir. And there's like this moment, this pause, and he's just like, I was called because you were over in the parking lot fighting with your boyfriend. And I'm just like, I just got home. Please, I leave my house for the first time in forever, and this is what happens. I was in the car. I got home. The person I brought home with me is a girl. Oh, that sounded a lot more suggestive than I intended for it to be, but there are no boys besides my stepfather on the premises, sir. So, there's this moment of I'm confused, he's confused, we're both confused together, and then the cause of this presents herself, just jumps directly into the situation, and that is one of my neighbors who I have known since I was young, and that is probably the only reason that any of my neighbors had me in their, just at the forefront of their mind enough to be like, I'm gonna call the police on her by name. But anyways, my neighbor approaches, and I remember this distinctly because she was in her flip-flops, and you know, like, flip-flops and robes. There's no judgment. I've gone out of my house many a time. It was just that it was a vision in my head because she approaches in her flip-flops and robe to clarify the situation. And no clarification was done because she walks up and she says, yeah, Cass, you know, that guy. And I am just like, ma'am, no, I don't know. I don't, what guy? No, please don't come here and try to, like, put me back in this. There are no men. No men. But yeah, she's pointing towards the parking lot next to my house and just trying to remind me of a situation I was not even home to have been a part of. So I don't know what it was. I really don't. I don't know if it was like a lot of people on my street use substances that might have caused them to see things that weren't there, and that's all I'm going to say on that, at least regarding this particular person, because what happened next was kind of an example of why I have apprehension about the police and why I do not trust them, and it kind of leads into issues I have with other neighbors, because across from me, you have the one neighbor who has called the police on me, and then you have other neighbors. Call them the other neighbors. And they do a lot of things. They do a lot of things that you would prefer your neighbors not to do. Everything that you would think, what do I not want to happen across the street from me every day, every night? It's happening. And it's loudly happening. That is to say that these neighbors are on many substances. And these substances cause them to be out on the street screaming in the middle of the night, cause them to be fighting, cause them to fight with you, which I'll get into that. But point being, I finally kind of, in my head, I was like, what, if anything, what happened here? Because I was not here for it. I was not even home for it. So finally, I turned to the officer and I say, look, that house there, the other neighbors, they are always fighting. If there was a fight out in the streets, it was not me. I promise it was not me. So I actually point to them. And again, I mentioned earlier, this is one of the points where it became clear to me that the police don't care, because as soon as I pointed towards them and the woman who had called the police on me was like, oh yeah, it was them, and starts walking towards their house. And so that's why I came to the conclusion that perhaps she was not in her right state of mind, and just, she heard something, and she was trying to get to the bottom of it. And I just don't know what she heard, but it had nothing to do with me. So we both point towards that house, and the police officer proceeds to get in his car and drive away. See, that's what gets me. If, God forbid, and I would be, with all of the ruckus, the ruckus that my neighbors make, with all of the fighting and the screaming and the most dramatic, weird things happen on our street. Up in my room, I can hear it all, so a lot of shit happens that I have to listen to. But it's something about knowing that that happens daily at a house that is basically open and loud about their illicit activities, but nothing happens. But if I go out onto the street and have an argument, they're coming for me. Like, whatever protection they're giving to them, whatever they're doing for them, I'm not doing it, because I will get in trouble right away. And, I mean, maybe the call was more just to make sure that I wasn't in trouble, but point being, with all of the screaming that happens on the street, it's hard for me to understand how they didn't give a crap. Like, if it was them, then that's fine. They can scream and cause a ruckus and keep us all from sleeping and fight with us, but he's only interested if it's someone from my house. Anyways, yeah, I mean, that's the bulk of it. I didn't actually get in trouble because I didn't do anything, but anyways, it's shocking to me that I can say that this is actually not the only story I have where I have a run-in with the police, or I had a run-in with the police in the last 8 months. And The other one I will actually take some responsibility for, although I still think it was blown out of proportion. But point being, I will cover that some other time. I'm thinking maybe more of a Halloween video because it scared the shit out of me. And actually, last Halloween, before I suddenly just stopped posting altogether, I had considered making a video on that. But at the time, it was still too fresh. I was genuinely traumatized. And I don't think I covered it from the perspective that I really wanted to because of my feelings about it. So I think I'd rather cover it now or once the full year has passed and it's Halloween again. That might be something that I want to cover because maybe it's a bit more comical in hindsight, but, you know, when you have something that actually literally scares the crap out of... Okay, not literally. It didn't literally scare the crap out of me, but look, you get my point. Like, it was scary. Pumpkin, what are you doing? He's very rowdy this morning because he is angry that I am the only one awake and the only one he can torment, but I am busy talking to my computer, which he does not understand at all and feels ignored. So I'm about to go and give him attention, but I am very glad to be back into this. I've missed it a lot, and I'll do a video that's more of a general catch-up, but I hope that everyone is doing okay with everything that's going on. I know personally what's been keeping me entertained and upbeat is having a lot of people to listen to on YouTube, so though I was having a lot of difficulties sitting down and actually getting myself to start, I felt like it might be important, an important time for me to try to do this again, because I think everybody needs something to listen to right now, and if what I say is amusing at all, if it brings you any joy, then I'm very happy about that. But I hope that you're all keeping as safe as possible and that you're following all of the guidelines to keep yourself healthy. And feel free to comment down below and just tell me how you've been. Tell me how things have been going and just chat with me. I actually started streaming on Twitch. I've taken a break from it because I was overwhelmed with everything going on. I actually have another video that I'm going to do soon about how in the span of a month since self-isolation started, we have had our internet cable taken down 3 times and we're basically cursed. But I will actually talk about that when I get to it. I have photo evidence for just how many times we have been fucked over in regards to... There's so many cars. I'm getting rambly at the end of the video, but it's fine. Look, the story's over. I just wanted to talk. Every time I tried to talk at the start of the videos, it would just take up way too much time, and I was like, this is not what people came for. But the end of the video, anyone who doesn't give a damn can click off, and they have gotten the story. So, yeah. Also, I think the speed paint's 20 minutes, and I'm at 8:35. But back on track. I hope that you're all doing okay. I really do. And I hope that everything gets back to normal soon. I'm frankly not very hopeful that it will because of people who aren't doing their part, but all you can do is hope and do your best, and I hope that the time that I've gone has been kind to you all. And yeah, I'm gonna be back on here soon. I kind of just had to break myself in again, I guess, because it felt like every time I would sit down to work on one of these, my brain would tell me all of the things that I should do instead. Since I have a lot of work I'm currently doing, but yeah. Hi, Pumpkin. I'm gonna give my cat some attention, and I'll talk to you all again soon. Goodbye. See you on YouTube. I almost forgot. It's been a long time, I almost forgot, but see you on YouTube.